Pokemon Let's Go.
Yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. So you're a Pikachu man, Reiner.
Yes.
Right? And then yes. Shay's an Eevee boy?
Yes. Diehard Eevee boy.
And Kyle, you have seen a lot of this game?
Yeah, it's weird. This is the first Pokemon since, like, starting with Black and White 2, I've reviewed every mainline Pokemon game that has come out. So this is the first, I consider this like a mainline one. This is
Do you?
I think so.
No?
Mm-hmm. Okay, never mind. My point is dead.
It's not a new game, but it is like, as mainline as like Fire Red and Leaf Green were.
Yeah, I'm excited to hear them talk about it because usually I'm on the other side of like having played a bunch. I haven't played much. I played it at E3. I helped you with co-op a little bit, Shay. Mm-hmm. But otherwise, I'm excited to hear about it.
Is the review on the site by now?
Yeah, probably.
Okay, what do you think about this thing overall?
I think it is a very good remake of the early games, like especially Yellow, because that's what it's really remaking. But like, you know, if you just say, hey, it's a remake of the first generation, that's probably pretty accurate.
You're
going through Kanto, you're encountering the same Pokemon you encountered in like Viridian Forest.
Where is that? Gen 1.
It's Gen 1, yeah.
What about timeline-wise?
It is basically the same time. Like there are things that like... they shift around the timeline a little bit. Like there are characters that like will reference things that like they like. It's kind of tricky. It's just a remake of the
it's
first.
It's close
game.
To Yellow. Okay.
Yeah.
And you say on the level of Fire Red or Leaf Green? Like how dumbed down is this thing? I think is the number.
It's a little
question.
Dumbed down. Like they got rid of some things, which is unfortunate. The main thing is with. Like catching wild Pokemon, you don't battle them anymore. You just kind of throw a ball at them, like kind of like Pokemon Go.
That sucks, doesn't it, Reiner?
Yeah.
Okay.
I that seems hated bad. It at first.
Yeah.
But I kind of like the streamlining now because like you're battling so many trainers along the way that like it's nice that it's set apart like from those encounters. Like when you know you're walking through an area and you're battling a bunch of trainers and then there's like a wild Pokemon. It's nice to just like go up to them and throw a ball. I know it doesn't really make much sense like in the whole like scheme of you have to weaken the Pokemon first and then throw the ball and catch him then. But with this, it's nice to have that separation between those two encounters that you can have.
I guess so.
But also, it makes some of the more special encounters feel that way. You know, it feels special where like when you wake up Snorlax, for example, that's like a one-time encounter. It's like it's meant to be set apart from like a normal Pokemon. You actually have to battle him in order to weaken him, and you only have 5 minutes to do it. So like,
okay.
I failed the first time because he kept using rest and restoring all of his health, and then like I kept trying to take him down. He would put me to sleep, go to sleep himself, restore his health, and the timer ran out, and it was just like Snorlax ran away, returned to the mountains.
Weird.
And the same thing for like the legendary birds and Mewtwo. You only have 5 minutes, and they also raise their stats. So like it's a pretty tough challenge to take
Weird.
These guys down.
Reiner, you hated Pokemon Yellow originally.
I remember yeah,
we read the game
that's
before
a
review.
Bastard of a game.
Yeah, but how have you enjoyed this thing so far?
That was a cash grab game. It's cool. Like Shay's saying, I didn't like that they took out those battles. I thought that was like a unique thing they did, where you had to figure out exactly how much health to whittle off and get them in the red to try to catch them.
Yeah.
But at the same time, random encounters are gone. So you see every Pokemon that's spawning, so you can kind of hunt for the ones you want. So if you're just walking through the grass and you need Pidgeys, you'd every once in a while catch stuff you didn't want. Now you could see them, walk over and touch them, initiate that encounter.
That. Like, I hope that's an ongoing
thing. So do I. I really like it a lot. And it's nice because, like, I've actually, like, dodged certain Pokemon to, like oh, Chansey just spawned over there. Like, it's nice to like, be like, all right, I don't need these Magikarp that I've caught seven of. Mm. Just, like, kind of, like, swerve to avoid them and then go right to the Chansey.
That's cool.
I think Pokemon fans, you know, they've wanted a console RPG, a real console RPG. Sorry, Gale of Darkness, get the hell out of here, you know? But, like, is this going to be satisfying? Is it still that kind of gray area where it's like, it'll kind of feel like what you've always wanted, but not really?
Yeah, I think it is satisfying. I think that it's nice that, like, you are, you know, even though there's some changes to the formula, you are going through the entire Kanto region. You're battling Brock, Misty, all the gym leaders, taking on the Elite Four. Like, and the turn-based mechanics are still there. They're still as good as they ever were. Like, there's a bunch of new moves and a few new types that weren't there when Gen 1 originally launched. Like, there's Dark and Fairy and Steel types. But, like, you know, it's still a remake of those first games. And if you love those games, you're probably going to enjoy these. They are a little easier. Like, I don't think I lost a single battle. the entire time I was playing.
That sucks.
But post game, I definitely ran from my Mewtwo encounter because I got there and it was like, oh, he's level 70 and also all of his stats are boosted and like he one-shotted all my best Pokemon.
Okay, what about experience share?
Do they bring that is there, yeah. That's by default. Also, if you get stuck, you can call in a co-op partner, drop in, drop out. So all they do is they shake the other Joy-Con. So you just play with one Joy-Con.
Really?
So there are three control schemes, and this is kind of the weird irony of this whole situation. Is it like the big deal about this game is what?
The Pokeball.
No,
that you use as a controller.
It's the first console Pokemon game. You just said it yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the big deal about this game.
I got it.
But the worst part, the worst way to play this is up on your TV because there are three control schemes. There's the Pokeball. Yeah. There's a single Joy-Con that you hold like almost like a half a controller, where it's like the you have your thumb on the joystick and you hold it like vertically, not sideways like Mario Party.
Yeah.
And then you can play it in handheld mode. If you're playing with the Pokeball or the Joy-Con, you have to like flick your wrist in order to throw the ball.
Get to flick your wrist, yeah.
You get to flick your wrist. And it's not super consistent. Like, so if a Pokemon jumps to the side, like they'll try to avoid your throws. And if like they jump to the side, I could not consistently hit one because like I'd be going like this and it would just go straight. So after a few hours of playing up on the TV, I just decided to play handheld mode, which that almost works like the motion controls of like Breath of the Wild, where you just kind of aim and then you press a button.
It still is very silly to get so excited about the console Pokemon and then be like, well, I guess handheld's the way to go.
Yeah,
here we go.
It's really, it's a bummer. Like, I hope that, like, I don't know how feasible this is, but I hope they patch it that you can play like with the Pro Controller or with the like the two Joy-Cons and just aim it that way and press a button.
Or have two Pokeballs in each hand, yeah.
Yeah, for me, it's just, it's nice to take a stroll down memory lane. Mm-hmm. You know, revisit this game, but
route
to your sorry to answer your question though, is it going to sate that appetite? Probably not.
Yeah,
because you just want new critters, and there's two in this game, which is kind of evil, in that they're tied to Pokemon Go.
Yeah,
but if you want to have the complete Pokedex, if you've played all the other games, you got to play this game just to get those two guys.
It's
the
Meltan,
one guy,
or whatever?
Yeah, and his evolution,
Meltan and Melmetal, I think is his evolved form.
Okay. I mean, as a huge Pokemon Go fan, is it more connected, less connected than you thought overall?
It's just, I think you just transfer between the Pokemon. Like, you know, like you can take your Pokemon from Pokemon Go and bring them into the thing that, another thing I'm kind of upset about, it replaced Safari Zone. Like, there's no Safari Zone in this.
Get the f*** out of here!
I'm pretty upset
me?
About it, yeah.
Why?
So, there's Go Park now, which just lets you bring your Pokemon from Pokemon Go and, like, import them into there. And,
what?
Yeah, it's...
Can you not use Pokeballs in there? Is there anything unique?
There's nothing in there. Like, there's... Until you import Pokemon from Pokemon Go, there's nothing in there.
This is an outrage.
Yeah, I was pretty upset about that. That and the motion controls are my two biggest complaints about the game.
Yeah. Oh,
you can pet Pikachu.
You can.
And okay. Eevee.
And customize their outfits.
With the touchscreen?
Well, I guess that's fine.
You can use the touchscreen if they're in handheld
or...
We'll
do that for a while. That's
you can rub their ears.
Yeah, that's not...
Yeah, you can decide, like, you can figure out what parts they like petted.
Yeah, that's one of
and then they give you a boost.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, they if like you develop a good relationship with a certain Pokemon, they will have like boosts in battles. Like there was one where like my Eevee liked me a lot, so he wanted to like make me happy. So what he did was like a really hard hit him, and rather than fainting, it stopped at 1 HP and it was like he didn't want to make you sad, so he endured the hit. And then there was another one where like good he was poisoned. And he's such a good boy that he expelled the poison himself, so I didn't have to waste a turn giving him antidote.
Yeah, you listening, Rockstar? This is horse maintenance. This is what you need to put in your dumb game.
But like, it also like encourages you to rotate the Pokemon that you're taking for a walk, because when they're out of their Pokeball walking around with you, like they'll be happier, so they'll also get those boosts. It's
I don't
not
like
just like
that
your
subtle
eating.
Implication that every Pokemon's happier outside of the Pokeball.
Oh, they totally are.
I guess. Kyle, I think I'm pessimistic about this game, and I want you guys to course correct me, because are you anticipating the same trajectory, and I'm curious if you guys had this trajectory, of love Pokemon, one of your favorite series ever. I'm expecting to start playing this game, and then after about an hour, just realize, now I just have to replay this whole thing, and it's going to be just kind of a emotional flat line of going through the motions.
I've played a Kanto game for this is my seventh time through Kanto.
Exactly.
So I like it. I enjoy playing through it. I mean, I just played Final Fantasy X for the fourth time this year. So it's like, I don't mind replaying a game that I love so much.
Yeah, but so if you're not dying once, it does feel like you're going through the motions.
No, yeah,
right?
I mean, it to an extent, but at the same time, it wasn't like a walk in the park. Like the Elite Four, I still had to stock up on like
okay
hyper potions and revives and all kinds of things to keep me going. But like, yeah, it wasn't like the challenge that Red and Blue were when you first go into that.
Of course not, yeah.
So here's one thing to mention, which I haven't played as much as these guys, but in terms of a thing that would like get you excited for this,
yeah,
I think this game looks way better like when you're playing it on your television than it has in any of the trailers or anything leading up
to
it.
Is that right?
This game looks really sharp. Like I was impressed when I sat down to help you play some co-op.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, wow, this looks way better than it has in like trailers and stuff like that.
Yeah,
I think it looks
really
good.
The battle animations are very
really?
Nice.
Okay. They've really, it's weird marketing because like they led with the worst part of the game, which was the motion controls.
Yeah. I don't know. That's kind of their thing. They did that with ARMS as well.
Reiner, mm-hmm. It feels like you're dying to talk about this game.
Oh, I just think if you are fond of these games, the nostalgia factor is high. And that should carry all the way through the game. Like, I'm enjoying it.
Okay.
Even though, like, I want new Pokemon.
Yeah.
But seeing them reimagined again, you know, in HD now, it looks cool.
It's a good step between, you know, Sun and Moon and what we're hopefully getting next year with whatever
Gen
8 brings.
New generation, yeah. Well, hopefully we'll get Towns first as another little step towards what.
What if
game
Towns
really
is
do?
Just Pokemon next game?
Oh, it's like the PT of Pokemon?
Or just maybe that's the start of that. That's like a it could be PT or it could be a prologue.
What if it's like a town inside of the
yeah,
world
that's,
Pokemon
that's,
where they just don't they haven't found Pokemon yet?
That's your pallet town, but yeah.
Wait a minute. What,
it
PT
ends...
Pallet Town.
Oh my
Wait a
God.
Minute. That sounds great. Another reason I think I'm being too pessimistic about this is like I heard you playing
you
like
hate
some,
fun.
I guess so. Maybe I'm in a surly mood, but I heard you doing some multiplayer battles and like, you know, I was editing videos about Warcraft and stuff, which is what I do all day. And then I could just hear you behind me just saying crap like, "Oh, looks like I got the first move. I look out for that fire type." You're being sarcastic in the way you're doing battling, and it's just like a reminder of like,
well,
is Pokemon battling just not living up to the year 2018?
I was battling
here?
Reiner, and well Suriel was using your, but Reiner has like level 11 Kakunas, and I have level 54 Articunos.
So that was the sarcasm. Okay.
But then we did a regular battle like where it like normalizes everyone to level 50
and then the floodlights came on
and
the
then
music
I,
was just
I
orchestral
was
swell
a level 50 Articuno battling a level 50 Kakuna.
Okay.
And I still wiped the floor with him, but you know.
Oh, interesting.
Reiner, you famously loved the Pokemon soundtrack in an episode of Replay a couple years ago. How's the music in this one?
I like the music a lot.
Is it all redone?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because Masuda directed this.
Yeah. I mean, it's redone versions of the same songs.
Yeah,
but
that's
like,
fine.
I mean, they're
songs.
Are you really coming down on this soundtrack?
Yeah. What?
Have you not watched that episode of Replay?
Maybe I was on
I
it.
Know
I don't
the
remember.
Episode, yeah, but
you might have blocked it because you were so mad.
What do you do with you in Game Boy soundtracks? You bash Pokemon soundtrack? You bash Super Mario
Game
Land soundtrack?
Yeah.
One of the greatest soundtracks of all time? It's incredible. Did you just leave your Game Boy on mute?
Soundtracks.
Don't get me started on that Tetris Game Boy theme. Garbage Town. Well, that's exciting. Review on the site. Very cool.
Yeah, GameInformer.com.
That's the one. That was just a clip from a larger show called The Game Informer Show. You can find it on iTunes, Google Play, or GameInformer.com. We take the fun opportunities and exclusive information from Game Informer Magazine and boil it into a show that airs every Thursday with exclusive cover story information, developer interviews, a lot of fun stuff. So come love games with us.